the shift is, you know, how do you deploy technology? And we are really clear about the whole technological aspect that we want to bring in technology that will provide our people with more efficiency, right? Mm-hmm. We our greatest asset are our people, our human capital. And so I'm looking, as I was the COO, now I'm the co-president, but we're always looking at innovative ways to apply technology into our organization. And about 5 years ago, I went on a mission to cleanse and unify the data in the cloud. And I'm really happy that we did that because we have a very strong data governance. So we're really poised right now to deploy some really interesting technology to arm our, not just on the investment side, but from our client service side, legal compliance, operations, in a way that allows us to be more responsive to our clients and to our employees, right?
So when you say clean up the data, is that to make it more searchable, to make it more
consistent. Okay. It's more about, we built data dictionaries. So the data itself was cleansed. It was just sometimes the way you tag the data. And so therefore, and I think that's something that people need to be really careful about when they start to bring on technology, especially artificial intelligence, because you want your data to be your data. You know, we looked at a variety of different options to outsource data governance. And at the end of the day, we decided, like, it's our data. We want to be responsible for it, but we'd love to outsource applications with firms that are really sophisticated in fintech, you know, to continue to leverage off that data and be more expeditious in getting the results.
How hard was it to do that on your own, though?
Oh, we were great. We created working groups, and I'm a big believer in the working groups because that brings a variety of people, multi-generational into the and cross-functional. So we had a lot of fun with it. It was hard work, but it was great because it was during COVID. So it really allowed people to stay engaged and talk to each other and get to know each other, even though they were in different functional groups and not seeing each other. So it was a great project. And we just deployed phase one of our new cloud technology back in September, and we're about to deploy phase two. So we're really excited, and it's working well.
You mentioned AI. How much of a component is that of that strategy as well?
We haven't hired any AI components yet. We're doing our due diligence on a lot of it, and I think it'll probably be a cornucopia of solutions. I don't think there'll just be one.
Talk about hiring on that. Is this going to be a third-party firm, or you're hiring internally?
I think both. I think you need to have both. I think you need to have a third party that'll constantly be rejuvenating the technology itself, right? But then I think you need to have, you know, some internal folks that also maintain it and are sort of those goalkeepers a little bit on what you're using and making sure it's deployed internally with our systems.
As you deploy that technology strategy overall, including AI, where does the benefit of that lie? Is it primarily within Guggenheim, or is there more of a shared benefit with the actual end clients themselves, meaning the end investors?
Well, first it has to be internally, right, to allow us to make more timely investment recommendations and decisions. I also think it'll help with, since we're predominantly a fixed income shop and, you know, we invest heavily in structured credit, securitized credit, private credit, bank loans, I think it'll really help with the covenant analysis, issuer analysis, all of our due diligence. And then after we feel really confident with it, we will obviously see if there's opportunities to share all of that with our clients.